What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and this past week was one of the more boring ones of the year. But the good news is, this is the calm before the storm, because things are going to start picking up next week, and they won't be slowing down for a while. So we'll discuss why that is later on in this video. But before that, we're going to cover even more new features and changes found in iOS 15, specifically Beta 4. We're going to discuss the performance and the battery life, the community poll, when to expect Beta 5, and a potential iOS 14.8, along with some controversial privacy moves that Apple just recently made, and they will be implemented in iOS 15. So we have a lot to cover. And if you guys enjoy these weekly follow-up update videos, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. It always helps me, you know, understand how you guys are perceiving my videos and if you are really enjoying them and want me to keep making them. So make sure to hit that thumbs up button down below if you do enjoy these videos. And of course, if you enjoy this video specifically. But anyways, let's go ahead and start off with some additional new features and changes found in iOS 15 Beta 4. So the first feature is very interesting, and this was discovered by a Reddit user you can see right here. And it appears that in iOS 15, the camera app will now be able to auto remove lens flares from the sun in post-processing. So I'm not sure if this is specific to, you know, devices, if it depends on if you have like a certain chipset in your device and above. That is unclear at the moment, but it looks like Apple is implementing something to remove lens flares from the sun, which could be huge because that's always been, you know, an issue when you take photos outdoors, especially when it's really sunny and, you know, you have those lens flares that kind of ruin the image. So it's awesome that Apple is working on a way to use AI, you know, to get rid of those lens flares. And speaking of photos, I also just recently discovered a new feature inside of Photos when we swipe up and we can view the metadata right here. And actually, if you tap and hold on the metadata where it says ultra wide camera, 14 millimeters, f2.4, if you tap and hold on that, you could see exactly which camera lens took the picture. You have to tap and hold right there to see it. And when you know, let go, it takes it away. But really cool. So it looks like it used the triple camera, the 1.5 millimeter or 1.54 millimeter lens. Now, another new feature that I talked about in previous videos but never actually showed is the live updating of contacts you have their location for. So now, if both of you are on iOS 15, you can see down here, it shows live and it's updating this person's location in real time. So you can see they're driving right now and you can see, you know, when they're walking, when they're driving, it shows a live update instead of taking like a minute or a 2 minute interval, sometimes 30 second intervals between refreshes. It's all live now and you can even see the green pinging off of their profile picture right there, which is really neat. A really cool feature. And again, you do both have to be on iOS 15 for this to show up properly. We also have a new feature inside of the Maps application. So Apple is continuing to steal the features from Waze, which I am here for. I love the Waze application. But you can see that now it shows your estimated time and traffic in the Apple Maps application. So I love this. First, we were able to report, you know, police ahead and report crashes ahead. Now we can actually see the time and traffic, which is nice. Now, I'm not sure if it will reroute you if it detects, you know, a quicker route. I'm not too sure. That's something that Waze still has the edge over Apple Maps for, but you can at least see the estimated time and traffic now in the default Maps application. Now, the shared width feature is a big one in iOS 15, and I just recently noticed that it shows up in Apple Music right here. So I knew it showed it before, like in messages and things like that, but when you go to the actual album or single, you could see who actually sent you that song. And when you tap on this, it will actually take you to where in that message thread they sent you the link to that song, which is really neat. I just like how it shows up inside of the music application like this. Also new inside of the App Store, we have App Store events. So they now show up like this. So this is a new feature in iOS 15. And the first one, at least the first one I've seen, was with TikTok and this TikTok summer camp right here. So when you search for TikTok, it shows. And then also when you go to the today view, and I don't have a screenshot of this, but when it was going on, it appeared like right down here, I believe, somewhere on the main today view near the top, not the very top, but it was like right down here somewhere. So that is a new feature that Apple, you'll probably be seeing more of that. You know, once iOS 15 gets released to the public, you'll start seeing more app events. So I guess it's in-app events, which is pretty neat. We also have a change inside of Fitness Plus. So if you're a Fitness Plus subscriber, you can now filter workouts by equipment. So you can see down here under music, you now have the option to sort by equipment. So if you just wanted to use dumbbells, or if you just wanted to use the mat or whatever, you can go ahead and sort by that. You can filter your workouts by the equipment, which is nice. Now, if you guys remember in my What's New video, I talked about how the visual lookup icon has been tweaked in beta 4, but unfortunately still on my 12 Pro Max, it is not working. So the visual lookup is not working, but here on my 12 Pro, it is. So when I swipe up on like a cat, for instance, you can see it shows the visual lookup right there. And this has actually been tweaked here in beta 4. So you can see a slight difference in the paw print right there. The location of it's a little bit different. And then also this right here, the lookup. So it says lookup cats. So it already identified that. And if you tap on lookup cats right there, it will pull up the results right there. So just some minor changes to the verbiage, and also the icon looks a little bit different as well. So when we go down, you can see it's like this sparkly eye now, whereas it was something a little bit different. It didn't have the sparkles before. And then when you swipe up, right here, you can see it fills in, and we do have the little lookup cats right there, which is new. Now, also starting in iOS 15, Apple has announced that they will be scanning your iCloud photos for images of CSAM, or abuse in children. I don't want to say the full phrase because I could get demonetized here on YouTube, but Apple is making a big move with implementing CSAM detection, and it has been met with a ton of scrutiny and a lot of controversy as expected. Because on one hand, it's great that Apple is helping catch predators and, you know, locate potential missing children out there. But at the same time, it definitely puts a dent in the privacy of iCloud and our photos stored there, and really just Apple as a whole, because they've really been pushing this whole privacy narrative for a while now. Now, Google and many others have been doing this for years, so it's nothing new, but Apple, again, has been making a push for mega privacy. But I'm sure that this seems a whole lot worse right now since it's fresh news and not even out yet, because again, it's starting with iOS 15 when it comes out to the public. But maybe once Apple clarifies this a little bit better and kind of ensures that privacy won't be impacted as badly as we think it will be, we'll probably have a different feeling towards this. So let me know what you guys think about this down below. I don't want to spend this whole video talking about this because I could go on and on and on. I debated making a whole video on this, but if you want a link to this article and a couple of other news outlets out there as well, a couple of different takes on this, I will leave those linked down in the description below. I think it's very important and something that I really want to hear your guys' thoughts on down in the comments below. So let me know if you think this is a good move from Apple or a bad move and kind of a breach of our privacy. Let me know what you think. Now, getting back to iOS 15 beta 4. So one thing I did also notice in beta 4 over the past few days is that Twitter, and I know a lot of you guys have said this as well, but Twitter is crashing a lot. And it even caused a respring on my iPhone 12 Pro yesterday morning. So it completely froze and then resprung after trying to load up my Twitter mentions. So that's the first time that's happened, but I have heard a lot of you guys say that, you know, Twitter is crashing a lot, and it has for me as well. So that is common. It's not just you. Just wait for, you know, Twitter to eventually update their app to not crash on iOS 15. Now, also, I have been having issues with the Now Playing not showing up on the lock screen or on the control center, or even with Siri sometimes. I'll play a song on Siri and it's playing, and then I just don't see anything up here in, you know, my status bar, or in my control center rather. And I go to play another song, you know, choose a different song in music, and it plays a different song on my iPhone than it's playing on my HomePod. So just some really strange issues going on with music and, you know, the Now Playing screens. So I'm sure that Apple is going to fix this in the next beta because it is a pretty major issue. So I would expect to see changes to the Now Playing in beta 5. And then also today I did have an issue with my banking app for the first time. So my Face ID just completely broke in beta 4. I don't know why. It just doesn't work for my banking application anymore. And I know a lot of people are having issues with their banking apps as well, and that is expected. Those are not going to be fixed likely until the official release of iOS 15. So you may just have to use your, you may just have to log in Safari instead of using the application. Or of course you could always downgrade to iOS 14 if it's a huge deal to you. I do have a tutorial for that if you want to watch it. It's linked down in the description below. But other than that, there really haven't been too many other bugs. I mean, really just Twitter and the banking app. That's really the two main issues I've been having on iOS 15 beta 4. And it seems like you guys are having a few issues, but really not near as many as we're in beta 3. So we'll talk more about those in a moment in the community poll. But before that, I do want to talk about the performance and the battery life. So as far as performance goes, like I just mentioned, really not too many bugs, and performance overall has been really good on iOS 15. Now, iPadOS 15, I have had a few issues on, especially with the World Series of Poker application. I don't know if any of you guys play that, but I have had some issues with that crashing and just overall lag. So it appears that iPadOS 15 Beta 4 is not quite as stable as iOS, because really on my iPhone 12 Pro, I've had really no issues besides, you know, like I said, Twitter and the Now Playing and just the occasional, you know, glitch and the occasional app crash, but nothing too major here on beta 4, which is a really good sign, because I think that beta 5 will be just excellent and really going to be one that you could put on your main device. Now, as far as battery life goes, battery life is still not great to me. So I talked about this in my previous video, but battery life is still just not great in my opinion here on beta 4. So if I go into my battery here on my 12 Pro, which I use every single day, it's my main device, and I have this on beta 4 right here. So I know the charts don't tell you the full story, but you can see I have, you know, you can see kind of my charts right there. So I do charge it a lot throughout the day, but I have noticed that I'm not getting quite as good a battery life as I was on, of course, iOS 14. So I'm still missing out on about 45 minutes of on-screen time here on iOS 15, the beta, compared to iOS 14.7 or 14.7.1. So still going to get much better battery life on iOS 14 than on iOS 15, but I would start expecting to see some improvements coming to battery life within the next couple of betas, now that Apple is really getting all these features out of the way. All right, so now let's go ahead and see what you guys had to say about iOS 15 beta 4. So if you navigate over to the community tab here on my channel, you can see I did post this just the other day. So I asked, how has iOS 15 beta 4 been running for you over the past week? And leave a comment with the device you're running. So we got 19,000 votes, so thank you to everybody who voted. I'm gonna vote for good, because that's how it's been for me. And it appears that that is the most popular, aside from being on 14.7.1 or lower. So 25% of people are saying it's good, just a few minor bugs, and it's not excellent with no major bugs and good battery life. So that seems about right, because that's what my experience has been as well. So you can see at the top comment, I pinned this and I asked you guys, is your battery life better or worse here on beta 4? And you can see it's way better. Battery is pretty good, better. For me, beta 3 had better battery life and performance, so that's interesting. And worse, someone said same, beta 4 battery life has been worse. People are saying it's bad, better. So they're talking about compared to other betas. So yes, beta 4 compared to other betas is definitely better, but it's not better than iOS 14, at least not for me and most people. So you can see there, that's everybody's response to that. So now let's go ahead and see what some of you guys had to say. So you can see here, Max has the top comment. It says, I've been having issues since beta 2 with Twitter crashing and battery life, but in beta 4, I have more stuttering, music on Apple Music pausing and unpausing, and connection issues on the AirPods Pro between devices, iPhone XR and iPad Air 4. So I have had issues with Apple Music pausing, and I thought that was just my signal, but it appears that maybe other people are having that bug as well. So someone's also talking about Twitter crashing in here and Facebook sometimes freezing randomly. So a lot of people having kind of the same issues I've been talking about. There are some bugs in the Photos app, and I can't switch between tabs properly in Safari. Other than that, it's pretty solid. Battery life is still worse than 14.7.1, but better than the previous beta. So I agree there with Smart Tech. And I've not had issues with switching between tabs in Safari, but you guys let me know if you've been having any type of issue with that in Safari. So Andy here has an issue with the iPhone SE second generation and Photos crashing. And Luca chimed in here saying he has the same problem with the same phone. So it may just be related to that phone, because I've not had any issues with Photos crashing. But if you guys have, let me know in a comment down below. But it appears, you know, at least 8 people have that issue as well. I'm not sure if they all have the iPhone SE second generation, or if that's a little bit more widespread and it's just maybe not happening to me. Andrew said that it's stuttering big time off and on. So that's pretty interesting. I've not really had too many issues with that. Not that buggy at all. So Logan here is talking about an issue that I thought was fixed in beta 4, because it was for me, but he says, problem is that Twitter doesn't have the same notification sound as it did before. So I'm not sure what's going on with the notification sounds, but it appears that they may not be fully fixed even still here in beta 4. Although I don't think Twitter has a unique, like a custom notification sound. So I'm not too sure about that. And maybe it does. I don't know. I don't have the sounds turned on, but it seems like there may be an issue with the notification sound still here in beta 4. Battery life definitely wasn't great, had a downgrade to 14.7.1. So definitely an issue with battery life for a lot of people, even myself included. Honestly, if I wasn't, you know, doing these YouTube videos, I probably would still be on iOS 14.7.1 just from the battery life alone. I'm on the iPhone XS at the moment, couldn't search in the app library, only bug I've noticed so far. So maybe some issues going on with the app library. Safari crashes on me sometimes when closing tabs. So Apple actually reported that that was fixed. So it's been fixed for me. I don't have that issue. I even demonstrated it on video, but maybe it's not fully fixed. So some people are still having the issue when closing out of tabs with the X on the search bar. So hopefully Apple does fully fix that in the next beta like they said they did in beta 4. So Jonathan here says that he's having issues with multiple notifications coming in at once, my alarm not ringing, and he's still having issues with the glitch with missed calls still showing up after clearing them. So that's actually been fixed for me. So when I would miss a phone call, you know, and I went to clear it, I would go out of the phone application, it would show up as one. That was on beta 3, but in beta 4, it now clears properly, at least for me. You just have to go into the phone application and on the missed call, stay there for like 2 or 3 seconds and then go out of it. And then you should see that notification clear, that badge clear from the phone app. But as far as the alarm not ringing or multiple notifications coming in at once, I've not had issues with those. So you guys can let me know down below if you are relating to Jonathan here. But thank you to everybody who commented in this poll as usual. I do appreciate it. I did read every single comment here on this community post. So thank you for that. And also thank you to everybody, all 19,000 of you who voted in this poll. It really helps me get a better idea as to how the beta is running for you guys. All right, so now what is next for Apple? Let's go ahead and open up our calendar here and talk about what's next for Apple. So iOS 15 beta 5 is up next. So next week is going to be the week of the 9th. That is when we should see iOS 15 beta 5. So it could come really any day from Monday to Wednesday, in my opinion. So it seems like Apple has really been favoring the Tuesdays and the Wednesdays. So the 10th or the 11th seem likely for beta 5. And let's jump ahead for a second and talk about iOS 15 beta 6, because I do want to talk about the upcoming change to the release schedule for Apple's iOS 15 beta. So before, from betas 1 through beta 5, it's going to be 2 weeks in between each beta. But after beta 5, I can see Apple switching over to a weekly release schedule. So that means that if we get beta 5 next week on the week of the 9th, which we should, that means that on the week of the 16th, the following week, is when we should see iOS 15 beta 6. And then from here on out, we should see a new beta for iOS 15 every week leading up to the final release of iOS 15, the final public release, which should be sometime in mid-September. So that's my guess. Apple does usually do that after the 5th beta. However, it could also be after the 6th beta. So we'll have to just wait and see. I am hoping though that we do have, you know, a new beta every single week after beta 5 comes out. That would be really nice. Now, as far as an iOS 14.8 goes, I do think that this is still possible to be released. Now, this has not been rumored, this has not been confirmed or anything like that. This is just purely me speculating. And I think that there is a possibility of seeing an iOS 14.8 next week as well, the week of the 9th. I think that the week of the 16th would be the final, you know, possibility for Apple to release an iOS 14.8 if we're going to go through beta stages, which we probably will. So I think there is a possibility of seeing 14.8 beta 1 next week as well. Although, of course, I would probably put that at like a 50% chance. There's really no telling if Apple's even going to release a 14.8 or if Apple's just going to do like 14.7.1, 14.7.2, 14.7.3, and just stay on the 14.7s all the way until iOS 15 gets released and even afterwards. So it's hard to tell right now. Apple is super unpredictable, but that's what the next few weeks looks like in terms of iOS release schedules. But anyways, let me know what you guys think about these releases down in the comments below. And let me know what you think about this video overall down in those comments below. And if you enjoyed this, I would appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you subscribe for a ton of iOS 15 content and coverage coming very, very soon. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.